I needed to make some rod leashes for a kayak trip, and I needed 7 of them. So, you know, they're not all that expensive, $5 or $6 a piece if you buy the cheap ones. But, you know, that still added up to about $40. So, decided I would make some. And I just made the ferrules, which you can see here, out of some 3/8 copper pipe. Let's get in the shop and I'll show you how I did it. All right, so we're going to start with some paracord. And this is just some cheap paracord that I got. I don't remember, like a dollar store or something like that. Probably not the best for marine use or outdoor use, but this is what I'm using. It's probably 3/16 wide or something like that. And I want mine to be about 45 inches long when I get finished. So I'm going to measure out 55 inches. And then what I like to do is melt it with a torch. Gives you a nice melted end. Don't burn yourself. It's not going to fray. Okay, so I got my cord cut. Now I need to make the ferrules that are going to crimp on there. And this is just a piece of 3/8 pipe. And I'm just going to cut a piece that's about 3/8 long. Now before I do that, I want to deburr. When you cut these, you roll a burr to the inside of the pipe. And that, if you crimp that down on the rope, you'll actually cut it. So you take a deburr like this or like this. You can also just use a screwdriver. Just twist it around in there. We'll do the same thing. All right. So then we're going to take a little pipe cutter. You could also cut these off with a hacksaw. If you do that, though, you're probably going to wind up with a bigger burr, and you probably just need to sand the ends of them a little bit. Now I'm going to cut probably about 3/8 of an inch off of here. The length is not critical. Just keep tightening up a little bit, and it'll go around and around. Now, when you get that done, you've got that little burr. You cleaned it on one side, but you got that burr on the other side. So you just need to clean that off. Again, you can use a screwdriver or just whatever you have. Take your time though and try to get it pretty much off of there. Combination of those two does a pretty good job. Probably when you get through doing the screwdriver, you would need to rub it on some sandpaper to get the top part off. Okay, but that's our ferrule right there. Okay, so to make our first attachment, we're going to measure off 10 inches. So this is my 10 inch mark. Okay, from here to here is 10 inches. Thread your ferrule on. Push that in there. Now I'm having a little trouble getting it in because of that blob on the end, so I can just take a piece of wire. Just take a piece of wire and shove it through. Okay, so there we go. Now what you want to do is just give it a couple of taps with a hammer to sort of flatten it out. Don't knock it down real flat, just enough to kind of crimp it in half. And then take you a screwdriver and lay it right on top. Get it right in the middle, like that. Kind of knock it down. Pull your rope out to both sides.
and then crimp it down. Nice and flat like that. Then stand it up on edge. So you're not gonna be able to see that. Stand it up on edge like that. And roll it over. Now don't beat it down hard, but just like that. And so that's gonna leave you with a crimp. Just like that. That's a very nice job. Gives you a really nice crimp. Just like that. And this is the end that'll go around our fishing rod. So now the other end, we just want to do the exact same thing, but this time we're going to insert a hook. These are stainless steel hooks I got off of eBay. They're just, if you'll search for a stainless steel carabiner, you'll see them. All right, so I'm just going to make another ferrule real quick. And that's got that one completed. Well, I hope this was helpful to you. You can use this ferrule technique for lots of different types of rope. Just get different sizes of copper pipe and use that. I guess you could also use stainless steel. Just be sure you get the burrs off or you're going to cut your rope into. Anyway, I hope this was helpful to you. Thank you for watching.